Hi, I'm Bob Alsop with ShopSabre CNC. Around here they call me RouterBob. Today we're going to do a walk around of the ShopSabre SideKick plasma machine. One of the reasons the ShopSabre SideKick plasma machines have been so successful starts with the way we build the base frames. You'll notice these frames are made of structural steel, the same material they make bridges out of, and it's all welded. So the entire base structure, including the legs, is really one weld. And you'll notice, even on the machine that's only 4 feet deep, we have a center support leg in it. It's all welded in. That's really important when you're cutting heavier steel and thicker plates, because that way the machine doesn't sag. But you know, there's another part that's almost as important as the frame on plasma, and that's how we build the gantries. The gantries on the SideKicks are actual structural tube steel, and we do that for a particular reason. One, it's very strong, and it basically matches the technology we use on our much more expensive machines. But you know, in this market segment, it's real common to find aluminum gantries on the machine. Think about that. Aluminum melts at roughly 1200 degrees, steel melts at about twice that at 2500. You know you're generating that kind of temperature down here because we're cutting plates out. Think about what happens. You generate all this heat. Well, eventually that heat comes up and it affects the aluminum gantry, and the longer you run the machine, the looser the tolerances get. Now, by using structural steel, and we also use structural steel tubular supports on both ends, that enables us to actually run the gantry higher with more clearance. That lets that heat dissipate. So that also makes the machine cut better and last longer. Now let's take a look at motion control. Defining the axis of travel is actually the first part of machine motion. Now that's actually done with, in our case, these precision guide rails. Now let's take a look at something. Within this market segment, you find all kinds of stuff. Now on the low end, you'll find companies that use V-guides with rollers. From the early 80s, you'll find companies that use round guide rails. That technology is early 90s. We basically use the same technology that we use on our high-end CNC routers, as do all the other major builders, and that's precision contour guide rails. And we do that because it's a much stronger system. There's no play in it. They're hardened steel, so trash and debris don't hurt them at all. So that creates a really, really long-lasting, a well-running machine. The other thing is, because of the loads, when we employed finite element analysis in the design, that gives us the ability to also put a CNC router head on this machine. So the gantry has enough rigidity to actually add that on the machine. Now let's look at what actually causes motion. We use rack and pinion systems on X and Y, and we use a precision ball screw on Z. In fact, the gantry has a drive system on both ends so that it's driven both ways. What actually causes those to turn are closed loop servo motors. Here's why we use those. Number one, they have more power. So more power means I can traverse faster, I can cut faster, I can go in and out of tight geometry faster, so the machine's gonna be more productive. The other thing that's nice about that, because of that power, that also gives me the ability to put a router motor on there in case I want to use the machine for plasma and for routing. So that's pretty much why we use closed loop servos. And if there's a problem, they detect it and stop the machine. Now, what connects those to the rack and pinion is actually our planetary drive system. Planetary drives are used because they're really, really smooth, and you don't have maintenance issues that you typically have with belt stretching in belt drive systems. We were trying to create a system that's trouble-free. The other part of the trouble-free part has to do with how we keep the mesh between the pinion and the rack controlled, and we do that with a floating system that we developed here at ShopSabre. Now, let's take a look at the last part of motion control, and that's machine control itself. You know, the number one question we get about the ShopSabre plasma machine controller is how easy is it going to be for my operator to use. So when we developed it, we kept that in mind. First off, we have a single screen interface, so it's really, really easy to use. And we run that interface in a Windows environment. What that gives us the ability also to do is to connect the machine to a network so we can transfer files from the office. We can also connect the machine control to the internet, so if we need to do remote diagnostic, it's very easy to do from the ShopSabre facility. So that's how we built this. And of course, another advantage is you could actually run software on the machine control if you wanted to. Now, let's actually take a look at how the operator interfaces with the machine control. You'll notice on the screen the buttons are logically organized. So for instance, when you see this group up here, these have to do with manually jogging the machine around. And of course, you can move in either direction, the X, Y, or Z axis. You can move incrementally, or you can move at a slower, faster, medium speed. Now, also, the buttons on the keyboard correspond to those, so sometimes you just use those buttons to jog. Now, the buttons that you find in the group below have to do with some routine functions, like, you know, one of the first things we do when we turn the machine on is we home it. So those functions are here. Now, this machine has an engraver on it, so that's what you see this button. Now, this area down here is real important because it has to do with how we actually cut materials with plasma. And let me dig into that a little bit more. Now, if you'll notice, there's a pull-down menu, and what I have said here are the types of materials that I use. You may not use the same material, so let me show you how those get configured. I hit the configure button. Basically, I say, here's where I list the material name and the actual cutting characteristics. Now, let me show you where those come from. We have a chart built in right down here, and that's where you get those settings of those numbers. And you notice also that all your consumables are listed here with their part number, so when you need to order consumables, you just go to the machine controller and you get the numbers. Okay, we'll close that. So basically, when I set one of these characteristics and save it, it shows up on this list. So for your operator simply selects a pull down for the material and everything's preset. Now, also part of this area is the touch height control system. Now, touch height control is really important with plasma because if we can keep the torch tip consistent above the material, we get a more accurate cut. All right, but that's where this is set. Okay, now, let's actually look at running a program. We go File, we go Open, we run the program or open it up, and we'll view it. And over here, this is actually represents the machine table or work area, and you see what the file looks like. So you can immediately tell if that's the correct file. Okay, once that's done and you're happy with it, you just hit the green button and it starts running. And as the machine's running, you'll see it actually draw the parts out here on the screen. Now, let's go take a look at the torch itself. This machine has a Hypertherm PowerMax power supply and a Hypertherm torch with a magnetic breakaway feature. Now, this machine has an option called a vibratory plate marker. Here's what that's used for. You can actually transfer information from your drawing onto the part. Now, that could be a location for a specific hole. It could be a label. It could be directions, anything. Anything like that can be put on there from the drawing to make it easier for the operator that does those secondary operations. Now, because of the way we designed the base frame and the gantry on here, we have the ability to add a lot of other options to the tool plate. One of those is a professional drill system. Another is we have collision detection if you want that. We can also put a router head on here. That's all because of the design of the frame. Now let's take a look at the table. The ShopSabre SideKick plasma machines feature a blow-through table. This machine actually has a water table option, which is by far the most popular. Now, basically the tank gets filled up with water and then we have a food grade additive called plasma defense that we put in the water, and that's a rust prohibitive and it's antimicrobial. Now, something else that's nice about water is it cuts the smoke down about 95% and it keeps the parts cooler. So that's why that's so popular. Now, some materials water doesn't work so well. In that case, we offer a downdraft table. Well, I'm really excited to show you the new features that we developed for this machine. If you have any questions, you can contact us at ShopSabre.com. Thank you for watching.